Well, welcome to day four of the athletics here at the Universiad in Naples. Distances start to get a bit longer now in this evening. After all of the sprint glory earlier, we now head for the steeplechase, and the women's 3,000 meter steeplechase it is. This title taken over 7.5 laps 2 years ago in Taipei by Tugba Gurvenc of Turkey, who got the better of Victoria Wagner Gürkiz of Hungary, and a fellow Turk, Özlem Kaya. Seven women have gone underneath 10 minutes this year in the lineup for this year's final. And whilst they not be able to challenge the likes of Beatrice Jepkoege, Noah Geruto, Emma Coburn, who won the last world title and is number three in the world this year, nevertheless, there is a gold medal at stake. Talk about Gubench back to defend the title that she won 2 years ago. Woman who has world championship and Olympic Games experience. She's yet to really star on the world stage in those two events, but she's certainly a star of the Universiad. Chiara Scherer of Switzerland. Also going, two Canadians, Catherine Beauchemin and Jessie Lacourse, both of whom do have global championship experience at the lower age group levels. We also have athletes from Sweden, the USA, Belgium, India, Ethiopia, two Ethiopians here as well, one of whom was in the 10,000 meters. We'll describe them as they go through this race. Poland, Argentina, and two Australians as well. We have a very demanding starter. Not happy even with the 3,000 meter steeplechase. So then we're ready to go. 7.5 laps, 28 hurdle jumps, including 7 over the water jump, 5 jumps per lap. Each of them nearly a meter high for the men, but for the women here, 3/4 of a meter. And unlike in the sprint hurdles, they don't fall down if you hit them, so you really do have to clear them, or you step on them and push off. And straight away is the defending champion who has gone in front. Tugba Gurvenc, who also was the champion of the under-23s, the Europeans, back in 2015, and she has taken them out and wants to make it a pretty honest pace. Following on behind her is one of the Indians, Toyota Kuhan, and the two Australians both at the front, or near the front at least as well. Paige Campbell, 23 years old, as is Bree Elada. Bree Elada, based in the USA, ran in the NCAAs this year, whilst Paige Campbell was fourth, just missing out on a medal in Taipei at the World University Games 2 years ago. Polish athlete that's going along in third place at the moment is Alicia Koniszek, 24 years old, has been to the European Junior Championships in the past. This is her first international championships, though, in 5 years. So then Guvench leads at the moment, Campbell behind her. Jagadari of India also going along. She's just 20 years old. There are two 20-year-olds in this. Catherine Beecham is the other, but the youngest in the whole field is the Ethiopian Akash Kinteneb, who set a PB in the 10,000 metres, finishing seventh around this São Paulo track in Napoli on the first night of action on Monday. Guvench's personal best, incidentally, at this level is 9.26, so she has comfortably the best time of the women on display, and she'll be looking to make that power and speed towards the end pay off and not allow them to have any chance of sprinting past her near the end. Guvench was 25 just 2 days ago as well, so this would make a very nice way to celebrate that birthday as they head towards the water jump. Sometimes see the men hurdling. Oh, there's a real accident there for the US athlete. That was not fun. I think that was Rasubala, the 21-year-old from the Northwest Christian University, who has been otherwise having a banner year, fantastic year for her. Times have been crashing down. Unfortunately, it was just her there that did. Just goes to show you've got to get that run up to the water jump absolutely right, particularly as the race goes on when you've got wet spikes and the top of the bar is also wet. Spikes are not exactly designed for going over steeplechase barriers. Guvench, though, still going out in front. Page is still pretty much the nearest one to her, with the pole. Konishek also in touch. Campbell Page, who won the Australian national title this year. She also went on and won Oceania Championship gold in Townsville as well. So she's very much in form. And they are beginning to get stretched out now as they head towards the halfway stage. Being joined at the front now by the Argentine Belen Caseta, 24 years old, a world championship finalist in London 2 years ago. Plenty of major championship experience for the Argentine as well, including a sixth place finish in this race 2 years ago in Asia. She's well placed there, right on the shoulder of Guvench. Well, the Ethiopian has come to the front. Well, Akash Kinteneb, obviously feeling good after that personal best of 34 minutes 23.99 in the final of the 10,000 metres. And she's got sprinting off. Well, the halfway stage is now on. Look at this for a break. Clearly, she's full of confidence. Now, is this too early, though? This is quite stunning. Personal best doesn't really exist for her in the 3,000 metre steeplechase, so this is new ground for her completely. She's run a 16:31.61 5,000 metres, which was also a PB right here in the heats of the 5,000 metres only last night. So she's run 10,000 metres, 5,000 metres, and now a 3,000 metre steeplechase. Heading into the last third of the race then. Things are really kicking off, and the gap is not getting any smaller at the moment. Akash Kinteneb out in front and beginning to stretch the lead even further. What will the others be thinking? She's so unknown, the Ethiopian, that they'll have no idea what this Ethiopian is capable of. 2,000 metres in 6:29, so they are, well, they're underneath 10 minutes at the moment. Whatever happens, this will be a PB for her, the third of the week. Oh, she landed heavily there, though. Didn't get much momentum, but nevertheless, she's still now some 20 metres in front of the field. This is quite astonishing if she manages to keep it going, but will the more experienced athletes behind her be able to do something about this? Now the pole, Alicia Koniszek has tried to break away from the pack. Guvench, the champion, looks as though she's beaten. She's going backwards and has dropped out of the back of that second chasing group, or that chasing group looking after the Ethiopian. The title is going to switch hands. The Turk is going to relinquish it. But at the moment, who is she going to relinquish it to? The chasing pack do not look absolutely full of energy. And will this Ethiopian be able to come from nowhere and take the title? Not if the pole can do anything about it. They head into the back straight. The Ethiopian is still moving quite well, Kinetibeb. Akash, as she should be known. Kinetibeb is the name of her father. Ethiopians start with their own name. Their father's name is their second name, and Menkir, which is her official surname on her passport, is actually the name of her grandfather. Well, the pole is moving well, Kinetibeb, but she's not really making any ground yet. The Ethiopian is still going. But will she manage to stay there? The gap is maybe gradually coming down. This is a good drive now. The Polish girl is stepping things up. Koniszek comes to the bell now, and Akash takes it, and the gap is coming down. All of a sudden, Alicia Koniszek is moving well. The gap is now down to 10 metres. They've got 350 to go, and it looks as though the Ethiopian is just going to run short of energy on this final lap. Then it'll be about whether she can take a medal, but there are two others chasing on behind them. Here comes the pole. She's got it under control here. She's going to take the gold medal. I don't think there's any doubt about that now. The Ethiopian perhaps just went a little bit early. And she loses the lead now with 240 meters to go. Alicia Koniszek, 24 years old, coming away to what will be her first global title. They're beginning to overlap those behind them. And the Ethiopian is being caught for silver medal now. Caseta, the Argentine, is going to come past her. But out front, though, Alicia Koniszek is going to come away and take the gold medal for Poland, a third of the championship, but a first on the track there. Gold for Poland, silver for Argentina, and the Ethiopian holds on for bronze. A marvellous result and great reward for the woman who's already run a 10,000 and a 5,000. And Akash Kinetibeb Menkir takes the bronze. Brave stuff. She looks disappointed, but I think she could be well proud of that, as is Koniszek. That was a fantastic piece of pacing. She didn't panic when the Ethiopian ran off into the distance at 5 minutes, just believed in herself, and she takes the title away from Tugba Guvench, who finished way down the field in this final. Well, the water jump becomes harder and harder as you go through it, as the American discovered. This was the point where, down the back straight, Akash Kinetibeb lost the lead, and Alicia Koniszek came away to take the title. Her first major international crown. It was a very fine race indeed. 9:41.47 was the winning time, by the way. So well inside 10 minutes.
Now it's 17:23, more or less at the same position. She's still in the fourth position, just one step to the podium.
And in one sense, Tugberg Uvenc actually served as a pacemaker through that early three or four laps. Defending champion probably thought she had a bit more in the tank than she actually discovered she did have. Confirmation then of the first major title for Alicia Konishek in 9:41.46 ahead of Belén Caseta of Argentina, who took the silver, overtaking the very brave Mesut Asmare Dagmar, who took the bronze ahead of Chiara Scherer. Poland third in the athletics medal table here at the 2019 World University Games, behind the Italians and the Brazilians, with the gold medal for Alicia Konishek, going with those that have been won by Konrad Bukovicki and Michał Rożnicki.